Welcome back to Harbaugh. A damning new report from an independent investigation on the September 11th attack on Benghazi in Benghazi criticizes the U.S. State Department for, quote, systemic failures and leadership and management deficiencies. Overall, the report takes the department to task for failing to provide better security in the run-up to the attack. In the wake of the report, three State Department officials have resigned, including the Assistant Secretary of State for Diplomatic Security and his deputy. Here's what the chairs of the investigation, former Ambassador Tom Pickering, and former Joint Chiefs Chairman Mike Moen, had to say today. Let's listen.
Frankly, the State Department had not given Benghazi the security, both physical and personnel resources, it needed.
The board found that the security posture at the special mission compound was inadequate for the threat environment in Benghazi, and in fact, grossly inadequate to deal with the attack that took place. The support the post needed was often lacking and left to the working level to resolve.
We've got more of that on the report and what it means for Hillary Clinton, perhaps the Secretary of State who heads that department. Andrew Mitchell is NBC's chief foreign affairs correspondent, and David Ignatius is the Washington Post foreign columnist. He handles all these matters. He's also associate editor of the Washington Post. I'm going to talk about, I called you today on this because it baffled me in reading it. There's two apparently contradictory reports in the report. One said they were repeated requests to try to get security forces brought to that Benghazi facility. And then later on it said that the people did not demonstrate strong and sustained advocacy for more security forces. Which is it? They didn't do enough? They did enough? How come they weren't protected?
It's both. It's that they repeatedly requested more security, and then when they saw that there were budget cuts and that there were people, diplomatic security officials being rotated out, they didn't push hard enough. So they asked, they were denied, and they then didn't come back to them and didn't really, you know, rattle the case.
Okay, now the real tough question. Is all that just doggerel passing of the buck? Is the real issue, if they'd asked and asked and asked and asked, if they'd gone all the way up to the top, would they still have been given a contingent, a significant military force there, given the CIA activities in that area? Would they have been given what they wanted, no matter how they asked for it?
I don't believe so. I did ask that question of Senator Corker today, who attended the classified briefing. I said, was all of this because there was a low profile? They didn't need a consulate in Benghazi. There's tourism going in and out of Benghazi. This was a mission, not even a consulate. But the real impact there was that they had a CIA annex, an outpost, that they had not even informed the Libyan militias about. One reason why the militias could not go to the to help them.
So we couldn't have a show of force there. We couldn't have a strong contingent.
They didn't want a big footprint. But Corker said he doesn't think that really was the problem in their defense. He said he thought it just was a failure from at all sorts of levels, not at the very top. They absolved Hillary Clinton herself of responsibility, although she says she takes the blame.
Well, that's a general acknowledgement of ministerial responsibility. The night of, in the heart of the attack, the peak of the attack, was there any way to get... I hear from a lot of conservative people, and people who are just very pro-military friends of mine, they believe, they have been led to believe, that we could have gotten forces to that facility in time to save the ambassador and the other people.
This report is quite clear in saying that that whole line of argument that has been used by people on the right, it was wrong. That it says the interagency response was appropriate and timely, but there were not assets.
Did we have
close
drone
enough
potential? Do we have force protection that was available we didn't bring in?
Evidently, there were not drones. Evidently, there were not AC-130 gunships, which would have been an alternative. The terrible fact, and I think the report is too easy on the military, frankly, the terrible fact is that there were no military assets close enough to protect those young people on the roof of the annex who were killed by a simple mortar attack. I mean, it's really inexcusable.
Yeah, 7 hours after they started. The problem is that the North Africa command that had been started appropriately because of al-Qaeda's growing influence there in North Africa was not located in Italy or any place close to North Africa. They couldn't get there in time. There was a drone that did get there and took pictures overhead, but it was unarmed.
Okay, let's bring this to human terms. When something goes wrong, people like to find somebody who's responsible. There isn't always somebody responsible. Some things break, you know. You start on this. Is it true that they were tough in their report, the Pickering report and the Mullen report? But in the end, are they saying this could have been avoided, really?
Yes.
If Chris Stevens wanted to go into a dangerous area, could he have been protected?
There are the two phrases that you heard Admiral Mullen use in the clip that introduced this segment. First, that there were inadequate forces there, meaning that there were requests for more forces. The Diplomatic Security Bureau and the State Department didn't act in a timely way. The Near East Bureau, which oversees that consulate, that mission, didn't act in a timely way. And the forces were grossly inadequate, an unusual phrase to use in a report
like this. Was that to save money?
For the attack.
It was partly to save money and partly to rely on the host. We don't have Marines at these kinds of places. We rely on the Libyans. The Libyans were not able. They didn't have a national government. They had these local militias that ran. They have overhead, they have camera videos, rather.
Okay, here's the question.
They have surveillance video, Chris.
Why did everybody think they were safe? Why did he think he was safe going in there?
That was part of his DNA. He had been in Benghazi during the entire civil war before he was ambassador. But we had pictures shown, video shown last week to the Senate of the Libyan militia getting into a pickup truck and hightailing it out of there at the first sign of trouble. And
will Hillary Clinton, the Secretary of State, as the minister in charge, have to eventually face the lions on this?
Yes.
Yes, she will. This was on her watch. Let me make one more point, Chris. One of the most important things in this report in terms of long-term consequences is it says the United States can no longer depend in high-risk areas on local security forces, meaning we're going to have our own forces either there or close enough.
Will they let us bring them in?
No. I mean, that's why this is a new world. This is the new normal is described in this report.
It means we can't be in these posts, most likely.
Some of them we're not going to be able to.
Lebanization of the world, it seems. Anyway, thank you. You don't want to hear that, but that's what it's beginning to look like. Anyway, thank you.
Thank you.
As always, I call you when I need knowledge.
I come whenever you call.
Thanks.